In the last tutorial, we have learned about e-commerce and the ethics related to e-commerce like privacy, fraud, and secure data transmission. Let's see some other topics related to it. Now, your next thing is, what do you mean by identity theft? Identity theft means stealing someone else's online identity, such as email ID, etc. Fraudulent posts are posted or some other malicious activity is carried out. It means that we are stealing the identity of some other person and using it as our own and doing anything, maybe malicious things or maybe not, but we are stealing the identity of some other person. Then the next one was, what do you mean by credit card frauds? Now, the credit card frauds is the credit card details of the user are stolen from his or her online activities. Means like someone have created a main fake website and they are stealing the user's credit card identity, and then some fraud payments are carried out without this stolen information. Means the card details that they have collected, they are carrying out some payment activities through that credit card. So these are the cases of frauds. Like first one is identity theft, then next one is credit card frauds. Then next is, what things we should ensure before providing our crucial information in a website. So before giving any crucial information in a website, what should we see? Now, the first one was, type the URL of the website. Do not copy or cut the link of website, or do not click on a link that takes to the website. Means, suppose we are having a website and we want to go in a website, then we should not go by any links that provided, like in a Facebook or any other websites, the links that are provided, we should not go through those websites. Like if you want to go to Flipkart, then you should directly type flipkart.com in the address bar, and we should not go by any other links. And so we should not cut or copy the links from the website or click on the links that given in the other websites. The next one is, ensure that the address contains HTTPS and a padlock sign. So HTTPS sign should be there and padlock sign should be there. So before providing our crucial information, we should see these two, HTTPS sign and the padlock sign. The next question is, what are the techniques to ensure secure data transmission? So how can we securely send out data? So SSL, secure data transmission. So SSL, as you have read, it's secure socket layer. So SSL technology ensures that the data transmission remains encrypted and safe. So SSL layer is used for data encryption, like in it is used in HTTPS protocol. The next one is data encryption, means the data that we are sending, it is encrypted, so it is hard to steal. So encrypted data is hard to steal. The next one is use safe protocols, like the SSL protocols. So we should use the safe protocols. Now let me show you a website to give you an example. Now here, as you can see, this is our CBSE website. Here the padlock symbol is crossed, means it is not secure. But since we are not giving any crucial information here, so that's why security layer is not required, because we are not providing any card details or anything we are not uploading. Then next is, suppose you are going to Facebook. Then as you can see here in Facebook, this padlock symbol is there, means the lock symbol, and this here it is written that HTTPS, means hypertext transfer protocol secure. So this, in this website we can hear the data is secure. That's all for today. Thank you.